Greetings, survivors and friends. SHADOWFRAX here, and whoa there! Easy!
Easy.
Yes, it finally happened. Since Helk's spur-of-the-moment decision in April to saddle himself with adding horse riding if the Leafs won, and after some initial stalling, this last week he finally ponied up, and right now admins on the staging branch can have unbridled fun with the initial tests. If you do have admin powers, or know someone who does, then a rideable horse can be spawned at the moment with spawn test rideable horse in the console on staging branch servers. All you have to do then is sidle up to one, find the sweet spot on the neck and press E to clamber on. You can also hit spacebar to get off, and pressing control allows you to rear up and give your neighbour a friendly hoof to the face. A few things to note. First of all, what you're seeing here is definitely not the finished article. It's extremely work in progress, with many rough edges, and a lot of bits will change before they're properly added. For instance, movement isn't the most stable thing at the moment. They don't like travelling over rocks, and definitely don't enjoy falling off of things, preferring to leave the planet to be with their people instead. But then, as we all know, horses need to avoid nasty trips, or it's a one-way journey to Lasagna Land. As yet, we don't know exactly how the taming mechanism will work either. Will it require us to bring some kind of offering to the horse? I know what I'd bring. It is, after all, the main thing that will truly get one on your side. But I have a feeling we may have to wait for another ice hockey match for that one, sadly. How long will taming last? Will we have to craft a stable? What about horse armor? All in all, the aim is to have horse riding implemented for the next patch on June the 6th, and Helk is doing all he can to achieve this, but stay tuned and I'll let you know for definite when I know. On a different tack now, and after just scraping through in a vote on Twitter, research costs are being slashed. And if you wonder why I voted for that instead of the horse riding option, it was out of principle. He'd already promised, so I decided to hold out for more. And you should be glad I did, because rare BPs have now been halved from 250 to 125 scrap each, and very rare are now 500 instead of 750. You'll have to wait until the 6th of June to take advantage of these savings on the main branch, of course. It'll obviously help out solos and small groups, and it'll be interesting to see how this change affects the speed of the game overall. But what do you think? Let me know in the comments. Gary continues his quest to rework Rust's menus and UI with a variety of videos of relaxing scenes from the game playing in the background now while you're there. As well as all the changes I mentioned last week, there's now a working store inside the game too, so you can get your skin fix without ever having to leave. Not that you'd want to. In addition, this week Gary decided to improve Rust's in-game chat, text, and other fonts by swapping the existing system out for another from the Unity store called Text Mesh Pro, the ultimate text solution for Unity. Oh, and it's free too. That'll save a few pennies. Here you can see a comparison between the old and new, and I'll let you judge for yourself. I also dust apologize for pointing out the vitals being swapped around last week to show the health bar in the middle of the survival sandwich. I know a lot of you didn't like this and couldn't see why it was done. Well, it seems it's nothing to get your thong in a twist about, as this was unintentional and has now been reverted. Phew! There were a number of fixes worth mentioning this week. Firstly, on the oil rigs, attention was given to projectiles being rejected by anti-hack when shot through stairs, a fix to one-way shooting through a window on the large rig, and various issues with false fly hack violations. Watchtowers can no longer be placed under the terrain to fix an exploit there. There's an additional barrel spawn location at the launch site office buildings to prevent 30 barrels from spawning in one room. Hate it when that happens. Key locks no longer use the code lock guide mesh, which looks a lot nicer, and both NPCs and dropped items no longer inherit the network group from their parent, which is the way it works for players and should greatly reduce the networking overhead on the cargo ship. Also, as optimization is number one priority, or at least it should be, you'll be dizzy to know that a new name has shown up on the commits list, and from what I can tell, he's currently focused on an experimental branch called pre-process copy, which is all about optimization. Not many details about this yet, but if anything, it's assurance that all your moaning and grumbling about performance is creating jobs, so you should feel good about yourself. In works in progress, as well as more enhancements to weapons VFX, there should be a big big change coming when the new work on environment shaders is done. Nothing to show yet on this, and it may be a while until it goes live, but I'm assured of great things. For map makers, there's good news this week as some new assets are being released for use in our projects, namely individual prefabs for the scientist compound and gas station, plus a few other bits and bobs. And finally, you know how most of you would probably change your character model if you could and have been begging for this feature for years? Well, you still can't. Unless you're an admin and you don't mind if it's only you who can see it. Okay, so now apparently there's a convar that lets admins change the seed of their character. But this is purely client-side, which means that it's only that person who can see it and everyone else still has to put up with their normal annoying ugly mug. It is useful for filming though. So this is how you do it. Simply type player seed followed by a number to change your character's appearance. So maybe you want to be this chap. Or this chap. Or how about this one? What about if you want a female character? Oh, that's definitely not upsetting in the slightest. Actually, it seems that's just what happens if you get too close to the females. So keep your distance. You've been warned. As the seeds are run through an algorithm to achieve the end result, there's no way of knowing exactly what each one will do until you try them. They're not permanent, and your character will reset when you rejoin. Also, you'll need to respawn for them to take full effect so you can see yourself in the inventory too. As I say, useful for filming and bedtime stories. Let me know, please, what you think to these changes. Please like, subscribe, ring bells, and generally give me as much engagement as possible to help the channel. I do appreciate it. You can join me on Twitch, Twitter, Facebook, Discord, and my Steam group too. Plus, support me on Patreon. Links are in the description. I shall catch you all soon, but in the meantime, keep calm and stay rusty. Cheerio.